Bendiciones, estar con nosotros en Facebook Live, en vivo con Facebook. We pray that you can receive something that I may say today is from the Lord. Algo que pueda yo decir del Señor, que venga del Señor para usted. Amén. Bendiciones a ustedes en Facebook Live. Amen. Well, last week we started talking about how to experience the abundant life, cómo experimentar la vida abundante. Estuvimos abriendo ese tema la semana pasada. Y quería seguir en eso. Well, I wanted to continue in that. So let's go to Psalm 103. Salmos 103 del 1 al 5. We're going to go to Psalms 103, 1 through 5 in your Bibles. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Last time we finished with if we walk in the love, love, si caminamos en la ley del amor, vamos a calificar, we will qualify for days of heaven on earth, por días del cielo en la tierra. God will give us days of heaven on earth. Dice aquí en la Biblia que Él nos dará días del cielo en la tierra. Now, sabemos que este no es el cielo. We know we're not in heaven. Heaven is totally different than earth, you know that. According to the Bible, de acuerdo a la Biblia, la tierra y el cielo son dos lugares diferentes. Pero Él dice que nos dará un poquito del cielo en la tierra. The way we walk and act like Christ, como caminamos, actuamos como Cristo, podemos tener un poquito del cielo en la tierra, dice el Señor. Amén. Entonces ahí es donde terminamos la última vez. Si caminamos en la ley del amor, if we walk in the law of love, love is a totally great foundation for us. It's what we're all about. De eso se trata el cristianismo, la ley del amor. So foundation for us always, it must be in love. Amen. That means we cannot hate people. No podemos odiar a alguien. You know, we can hate what they do. Podemos odiar lo que hacen, pero no podemos odiar a una persona. We can't hate a person. We must pray. Tenemos que orar por las personas. Tenemos que love, accept, and forgive. Hemos dicho eso siempre. Amar, aceptar, y perdonar. That's the way of the Lord. Esa es la manera de Dios, ¿verdad? So, Psalms 103, Salmo 103. We're going to continue there talking about, praise the Lord, how to experience the abundant life. Cómo experimentar la vida abundante. Now, when I say abundant, some people may think right away, oh, prosperity, money. Cada vez que uno oye la palabra abundancia o abundante, uno dice, ah, prosperidad. It's part of it. Es parte de eso. It's hard to not talk about the things of God without knowing that we're supposed to live abundantly. Es difícil no hablar de las cosas de Dios sin decir que debemos de vivir abundantemente, because God wants it that way. Dios quiere eso para nosotros. No debemos de ser pobres. We shouldn't be poor. Not being born again Christians. Ser cristianos nacidos de nuevo, no debemos de ser pobres. You see, the only reason we're poor is because we're not learning His way of doing things. La única manera que a veces nos metemos en la pobreza es porque no hacemos la manera de Dios. No hacemos lo que Él dice. Su voluntad, His will. That's the only reason why people are poor. Because they're like with their lives say, talk to the hand. Háblale a la mano. I don't want to deal with all that. But you can't be doing that to God. Talk to the hand. That's a devilish thing. Eso es diabólico. Talk to the hand. Talk to the hand. The world picked that up years ago. Talk to the hand. Háblale a la mano. Háblale a la mano. And people use that, you know. It's like saying, whatever. Lo que sea. Don't say whatever. You know, we got to watch that. My wife gets after me if I say something. Mi esposa está atrás de mí si yo digo algo. Yeah. No, forgive me, Lord. Perdóname, Señor. I don't want to say that word. No quiero decir esa palabra. Forgive me, Lord. It's okay to say forgive me, Lord. If you mess up, si no la haces bien o dices una palabra correcta, para y examínala. Just stop and examine the word you just said. And just say it. Forgive me, Lord. That's not what I should be saying. Perdóname, Señor. Esa palabra no debo de estar hablando. You know, forgive me, Lord. I'm going to change that word. You know, don't get offended by someone in love correcting you. No se ofenda si alguien en amor le corrige. You know? Because words and wrong words can eventually kill us. Palabras equivocadas eventualmente nos matan. It separates us from the abundance of what God wants to do for us. nos separa de toda la abundancia que Dios quiere para nosotros. Amén. So we are at Psalm 103, Salmo 103, and we're going to read here 1 through 5. This is awesome right here. This 103, es poderosa esto. Bless the Lord, bendice, dice, bless the Lord, oh my soul, bendice alma mía a Jehová. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Soul, alma, okay, what is your definition of soul? ¿Cuál es tu definición del alma? Because right here it says, the soul is the mind, the will, the emotion, the intellect. El alma es la mente, la voluntad, sentimientos, emociones, intelecto. Ese es el alma. That's the soul. So all that, it says here, needs to bless the Lord. Todo eso necesita bendecir al Señor. You know? And all that is within me. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bendice alma mía Jehová y bendiga todo mi ser, su santo nombre. And all that is within me, bless his holy name. Whatever is in you, lo que está dentro de ti, you must bless the Lord with everything you have inside of you. Lo que está dentro de ti, bendice al Señor, aleluya. Alce la mano y te diga, te bendigo, Señor. Just say, I bless you, Lord. I bless you with everything of me. With whatever I have inside, I bless you. Todo lo que tengo adentro, te bendigo. Te bendigo, Señor. Mi alma te bendice. My soul blesses you. My soul blesses you. Te alabo, te adoro. Bendigo tu presencia. I bless your presence. Gracias, Señor. ¿Ve? La palabra dice algo y lo hacemos. Ay, qué raro lo que ustedes hacen. Oh, you guys are weird what you do. Hermanos, eso es hacer lo que dice la Biblia. La Biblia dice algo, usted nomás actúe. If the Bible says something, you act it out. That's it. Be like a little child in order to enter the way of God. Sé como un niño para hacer las cosas de Dios. Just be like a little child. All these little kids right here, they're all innocent kids. Innocent kids. Innocent virgin kids. Niños, vírgenes, inocentes. They're just gonna do whatever you tell them or they see you do. Ellos van a hacer lo que ustedes les dicen o lo que ellos ven que tú haces. They're copycats. For a long time, they're going to be copycats. Mm-hmm. Huh? If daddy's going to go like this, the little kid's going to follow daddy. Ahí va atrás de daddy. If mama's going to walk like that, then the other one's going to walk like mama. Kids are imitators. Le gusta hacer imitadores, you know? If in the house you talk about God, si en la casa hablas de Dios, your kids will start talking about God. Amen. Tus hijos comenzarán a hablar de Dios. If you put certain music at home of God, they're going to enjoy that kind of music. Yes. Tú pones música de Dios en la casa, ellos les va a gustar eso. You put the other music, wow! That's the way your kids are going to be, just like that. Así van a ser tus hijos, igualito. Oh, I don't understand why my kid, why is he turning out that way? ¿Por qué está saliendo ese hijo? Look at yourself in the mirror. What are you doing? Did I do that? Yo hice eso. You know? Children are watching. You have children, they're going to be watching you. ¿Tienes niños? A veces hay un niño, una niña, a little boy, little girl that say a cuss word. I know right away, mom and dad do that at home. El momento que el niño y la niña dice una mala palabra, papá y mamá hablan así en la casa. That's what mom and dad talk at home. It's not the baby's fault. Huh? So, they're watching us. Babies are watching us. Children are watching us. Los bebés, los niños nos miran. They want to copy. Quieren copiar. They don't know any better yet. They're growing up. They're still, todavía están así. They haven't gone to that age of understanding, oh, right and wrong. I got it now. Amen. Lo correcto y lo no correcto. Oh, okay. You know? So it says right here, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bendice alma mía, Jehová, y bendice a todo mi ser su santo nombre. Verse 2, verso 2. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Bendice alma mía, Jehová. And forget not all his benefits. Y no te olvides ninguno de sus beneficios. When you bless the Lord, there's benefits for us. Tú bendice al Señor, hay beneficios. Yes. That's what the Bible says. I'm only going to tell you what the Bible says. I don't give you my opinion. Yo no te doy mi opinión. Because I have to live by this. You can't live by my opinion. Tú no puedes vivir por mi opinión. You have to live by what I say from the word. Lo que yo digo de la palabra. You know? You remember that in Guyana in South America? Guyana?
Guyana
in South America? El Jim Jones, el predicador, a Christian pastor.
Yes.
He took like almost 1,000 people over there to live in a commune. Los llevó allá a vivir en una comunidad. Because they were looking at him as God. Lo estaban mirando a él como un Dios. He was a pastor. Great pastor at the beginning. He was packing the church up. La iglesia se llenaba y todo. Pero llegó un día en que él, en la mente, dejó que entre Satanás. He allowed Satan to come in. And then he started sleeping around with women in the church. Comenzó a dormir con mujeres de la iglesia. Then he started sleeping around with men of the church. Comenzó a dormir con hombres de la iglesia. You know? And because he was God. Para ellos comenzó a ser un Dios. He became like a God. So he started saying, we're going to go far away and start just us. Guyana. Guyana in South America. South America. And they said, we're going to go ahead, and one of those times, he said, una de esas veces dijo, we're going to go ahead and have a communion service. Vamos a recibir comunión hoy día. La sangre de Cristo y el cuerpo. The blood of Jesus and his body. Y lo que hizo fue le metió veneno. It stuck poison in the communion table. So they all followed him. He was crazy. Se volvió loco este pastor. Satan got in there and destroyed this work. Destrozó esta obra. And they all died. Like 900 and something dead. Niños, mujeres, hombres, familias, abuelos, tíos, todos murieron. Porque siguieron a un hombre que lo vieron como Dios. They followed a man that they say, he's God. Para nosotros, él es nuestro Dios. You know? Por eso yo no puedo dar opiniones. That's why I can't give you opinions. I'm only going to give you the word. You know? It was sad. Muy triste. 900 and something families died. They came in planes to that area. And they were all the floor dead all over the land. En todo el terreno estaban todos tirados muertos por ese veneno. For that poison that they did. It was their last communion service with poison. This guy was crazy. Se volvió loco este pastor. You know. That's why it's so important that you follow your pastors with the Bible. Por eso es importante que tú sigas tus pastores con la Biblia. Para que tu pastor no ande yendo por acá. Y ustedes, wait a minute. How come he never talks about the Bible anymore? ¿Por qué ya no habla el pastor Luis de la Biblia? Y me estoy yendo por allá siempre y nunca regreso a la Biblia allá. You gotta stay in the Bible. Your messages, there has to be Bible. Tiene que haber Biblia en los mensajes. Amen. So, continuing here. Bless the Lord, O my soul, forget not all his benefits. So, vamos a ver los beneficios. Dice aquí, no te olvides ninguno de sus beneficios. Verse 3, he forgives all your iniquities. Él perdona todas tus iniquidades. Wow, everything I've done wrong, todo lo que he hecho mal, God will forgive all your iniquities. Dios perdonará tus iniquidades. Oh, thank you, Lord. We all can go to God and get forgiven. Todos tenemos la habilidad de ir al Señor para que nos perdone nuestras iniquidades. Amén. ¿Qué otra dice aquí? He will heal all your diseases. Él te sanará todas tus dolencias, tus enfermedades. Amén. Hermana María. María, ¿verdad? ¿Es María? Hermana María. Dios le sanará todas sus dolencias, todas enfermedades, todas cosas que a veces no sabemos por qué está pasando esto. Sometimes we don't know why that's going on. But I'm telling Sister Maria that God will heal her. If she needs the healing, she has to believe. Ella tiene que creer nomás. Y el resto, Dios hará. God will do the rest. Amen. So we see here, forgiveness of iniquities, perdona iniquidades, heals all our diseases, sana todas nuestras dolencias. And that's not all. There's more. Hay más. He redeems our life from destruction. Él rescata del hoyo nuestra vida. If our life is going down in a hole, he rescues us. Él nos rescata del hoyo. de la destrucción. You know? And then it says, He crowned us with loving kindness. Él nos corona de favores y misericordias. He crowned us with loving kindness and tender mercies. Loving kindness and tender mercies. God is crowning us. Dios nos está, dice aquí, coronando de favores y misericordias. You need mercy today? ¿Necesita misericordia hoy día? Ahí está Dios. There's God. Huh? ¿Necesitas favores? You need loving kindness, favors? He's there. He's there for you. Ahí está para ti. There's more. Verse 5. Verso 5. Él es el que satisface mi boca con cosas buenas. Él sacia de bien mi boca. He satisfies my mouth with good things. Why are you talking filthy? ¿Por qué estás hablando porquería de tu boca? He says he will satisfy your mouth with good things. Él satisface, sacia tu boca, you know, whatever comes out. Instead of saying, I'm old now, I'm gonna die soon. Estoy viejo, voy a morir. Ya pronto voy a morir. No hables así. ¿Por qué estás hablando así? Why do you talk that way? Toda mi familia era así, así que yo también voy a ser así. All my family was like that, so I guess I'll be like that too. Why are you talking like that? ¿Por qué estás hablando así? You know? So, let's see here. So, He satisfies our mouth with good things. Él sacia de bien tu boca. So that thy youth is renewed like the eagles. When He satisfies our mouth, when we start speaking right, cuando Él comienza a saciar de bien nuestra boca, quiere decir que hablemos bien, no mal. Speak well, not bad or evil. Speak well. He says He will satisfy our mouth. And what does that do? ¿Qué hace cuando hablamos bien? What happens when we start talking the right talk? Cuando comenzamos a hablar, el hablar correcto. The answer is right there. De modo que te rejuvenezcas como el águila. Once you get your mouth with good things, your youth will be renewed like the eagles. Cuando tú comienzas a poner las palabras correctas y comienzas a hablar bien, vas a tener un vigor. You're going to be vigorous. You're going to be energetic and energético. You're going to think young again. Vas a pensar joven otra vez. No importa la edad. It doesn't matter what age you're at. You start, you know, energized, energético. You know, you gotta get out there. And when you're talking right, things will happen right. Cuando hablas bien, las cosas trabajarán mejor para tu vida. Amen. So, the way I speak is what's going to help my body and my life. Como yo hable, va a ayudar mi cuerpo, mi vida y cuánto yo quiero seguir adelante. My body, my life, how much I want to go forward. O ya, con lo que digo, ya, aquí está bien, ya quiero irme con el Señor. This is good enough, I want to go with the Lord. Está bien, con todo respeto, si ya estás lista, está bien. We all have that ability. Tenemos toda la habilidad de decir, hasta aquí ya, suficiente. Ya no quiero más en la tierra. I don't want no more of the earth, I'm ready to go home with the Lord. Estoy listo para irme con el Señor. Amén. Se te puede aconsejar que todavía hay más, pero si tú sigues diciendo, we can advise you that there's more for you. But if you keep saying, no, ya no quiero, no podemos forzar a nadie. You can't force people to live long. Tú no puedes forzar a alguien que viva largo si ellos dicen, ya no quiero, déjame en paz. Leave me alone. I don't want to live long. Okay. Just pray for them. Ora por ellos. Because you're going to get them upset. Se van a enojar. It's going to be a fight. Van a pelear. You know, you can't impose your will on somebody. Tú no puedes imponer tu voluntad sobre otra persona y decir, haz esto. Puedes aconsejar, you can advise. Puedes ayudar, you can help. Pero lo más importante es preparación de intercesión en oración para preparar ese corazón. Sí. It's more important to in intercession and prayer, prepare the heart of the person para que te reciba. So they can receive you. So when you talk to them, okay, yeah, you're right. Estás correcto. Sí, yo deseo hacer eso. I want to do that, you know. So, but we can't force anybody. No puedo forzar. I can't force anybody to come to church, whether there's a pandemic or not. Aunque haya pandemia o no haya, yo no puedo forzar a nadie. I can encourage you to come. Puedo animarte a que vengas, pero no puedo forzar. Okay. No, you're not going to receive. No vas a recibir. Porque tengo que amarrarte aquí con una soga. I gotta tie you down so you won't leave. Huh? You come from your heart. Tú vienes con tu corazón a Dios de agradecimiento. You come with a grateful heart. Amen. Dice el canto, give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks. Because He's given. Jesus Christ. Da gracias con corazón de gracia. You know?
Porque ha dado a su Hijo.
Jesucristo. It's a beautiful song. Ya la han oído. No tengo todas las palabras, but anyways. Dar gracias porque Él nos dio Jesucristo. Give thanks because He gave us Jesus. You know? And live the best you can in obedience to His will. Vive lo más que puedas en obediencia a su voluntad. Él ya dio a Jesucristo, no lo va a dar otra vez. Jesus is not going back on the cross. It was only a one time. Solo era una vez. He's not going back on the cross. Ya pasó todo eso. The rest is up to you. Si hay que predicar salvación, if we need to preach salvation, we will do salvation for people. Claro que hay que predicar salvación. If it's a reconciliation, si hay que predicar reconcíliate, hay que reconciliarse. Claro que sí. Amen. You know? Somos embajadores de reconciliación. We are ambassadors of reconciliation. Así que constantemente tenemos que llamar otra vez a los que necesitan reconciliación. Esto no para, hermanos. This never stops. The Christian message and the Christian life. El mensaje cristiano y la vida cristiana nunca para. You're always either calling people to salvation, o estás llamando a gente siempre a la salvación, o you're calling them to reconcile again with God. O los llamas a reconciliarse con Dios. You know? Or you lay hands on the sick. O estás poniendo manos sobre los enfermos. And God through you will heal. Y Dios por ti sanará. By your obedience of faith. Por tu obediencia de la fe sobre otros. Amen. So, this Christianity is not just a once a week. La cristianidad no es solo una vez a la semana. This is your lifestyle when you're a Christian. It's a lifestyle. Mi estilo de vida. You know? When I used to go to the other church when I was a kid, the one you do this kind of stuff, you know? That kind of church like that. I would just go because parents say you gotta go. Yo iba porque los padres decían, but I didn't understand nothing, you know, no entendía nada. You know, I would just be bored, aburrido. Sometimes they speak in another language, like Latin. Hablaban en latín en esos tiempos también, en la iglesia. No se entendía nada. But you felt good because it's the right thing to do. Tú te sentías bien porque era lo correcto que hacer. La religión, religion. Hay que respetar la religión, que sea una vez a la semana. Maybe once a week, give to God some time because He'll take care of the 6 days. Él te ayuda los otros 6 días. Well, yeah, it's a good thing. Es algo bueno. But what are you learning? ¿Qué estás aprendiendo? You must learn something. Because what you learn, what we're talking about right now, you know, you learn about how to speak different when you go to the Bible. Cuando tú vas a la Biblia, aquí te dice cómo hablar diferente. Other places just talk about, you know, religión y todo eso. So you have to do something about it. Tú tienes que hacer algo acerca de esto. You can't just be a one-day Christian. You got to get more involved during the week with your Bible. Tienes que envolverte en tu Biblia. You know? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So, He satisfies my mouth with good things. Él satisface mi boca con cosas buenas. So then I can say my youth is renewed like the eagles. Para que se rejuvenezca como el águila, mi juventud. The more I talk like God talks, I won't be like an old man. Ya no voy a ser un hombre viejo, pero siempre voy a estar lleno de lo de Dios. I'm always going to be full of that God stuff. La cosa de Dios. Va a estar uno. Y eso te rejuvenece. When you have God's ability and life in you, tienes la habilidad, la vida de Dios, you feel young. Te sientes joven. But when you're not doing nothing, it's just a duty, religious duty. Okay, bye bye. Un día a la semana. One day a week. We'll see you next week. Solo estás haciendo religión. You're just doing religion. Así que es importante que si no puedes durante la semana solas, if you can't be on your own seeking this, that's why you come to a Wednesday or a Friday or a Monday. Por eso viene un miércoles para otra vez, un lunes o viernes para orar, to pray. So use whatever help you can get to build yourself up. Usa toda la ayuda que puedas para edificarte más y más. Por eso es que algunos vienen lunes, miércoles, viernes y domingo. That's why some people come Monday, Wednesday, Friday, Sunday. You know? En vez de quedarse en la casa a ver televisión, 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 just watch TV, TV, TV. A veces se repiten los programas, the same show, same shows. Ah, this show I remember when I was 10. Now you're 60. I want to see it again. What are you learning from it? ¿Qué estás aprendiendo? Just how to laugh for a moment. ¿Cómo reírte por un ratito? But when you need prayer, can you go to those shows? Cuando necesitas oración, can you say, hey, excuse me, channel 7 or cable, cable. Someone pray for me. I need help. Necesito ayuda. No, call your pastors. Go talk to your pastors. Anda a hablar con tus pastores. That's what the pastors are here for. Para eso están tus pastores aquí, para hablar contigo. Can we meet sometime? Sure. Here's my time. How's your time? Let's meet. Vamos a encontrar. That's what we're here for. It's not just to give you, okay, here's a word. I'll see you in a week. No, we're available all the time. We just got to connect. Estamos disponibles todo el tiempo. Tenemos que conectar nomás. And see where our time is. ¿Dónde está el tiempo? ¿Verdad? So verse 2. Regrese al verso 2. Go back to verse 2. 103:2 of Psalms. Salmo 103:2. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Forget not all his benefits. What are we to remember? ¿Qué es lo que tenemos que recordar? All his benefits. Forget not. No te olvides. Los beneficios. See, once you know the benefits... You know when you have car insurance, cuando tienes seguro de carro, some people just get liability just to have something. ¿Cómo se dice liability? Liabilidad. Algo así, liabilidad. You know, just simple. But when you get full coverage, cuando agarras lo completo, you feel even better. You know, I know. Le pegaron al carro, so no tengo liability. I only have liability. Let's get out of here. And you want to get away. Quiere alejarte porque no tienes full coverage. But when you got full coverage, what's going on there? You want to talk to the person. Quiere salirte a hablar y todo, you know? But when you have liability, let me out of here. I don't have full coverage. No estoy completo con el seguro. You know? That's how the Bible is. The Bible's got all the benefits you need. Toda la Biblia habla de los beneficios de Dios para nosotros, los que queremos realmente servirle. The ones that really want to serve Him, you have all the benefits that you need in this book, en este libro. You just gotta read them and get them in your heart and speak them in your mouth. Tienes que leerlo, ponerlo en tu corazón. Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. De la abundancia el corazón va a hablar tu boca. What do you have in abundance? Well, I have this show and that show and this movie and this MTV. ¿Qué tienes en tu corazón? Tengo MTV de música. Tengo tres programas. Tengo el comedy show de acá. Tengo cable. Out of the abundance of your heart, what are you going to speak? De la abundancia de tu corazón, ¿qué vas a hablar? Well, let's talk about movies. I'm always into movies. But see, that's good, but... Where's the spiritual? ¿Quieres hablar de películas? ¿Pero dónde está lo espiritual? I still gotta learn. Okay, good, learn. Aprende. It's okay. That doesn't mean you're so weird. No quiere decir que eres tan raro. It just means that you just need to step up and get in it. Step up, come on. Huh? Step up. Entre adentro, eso es todo. So, todos sus beneficios. We are to remember all his benefits. Tenemos que recordar todos sus beneficios. And we just read all the benefits. He forgives all our iniquities, which is also injustice. Él perdona todas nuestras iniquidades, nuestras injusticias. He heals all our disease. Sana todas nuestras enfermedades, dolencias. He redeems our life from destruction. Él redime nuestra vida de la destrucción. He crowns you with loving kindness and tender mercies. Él te corona loving kindness is favores y misericordias. So he crowns you with favors and mercy, loving kindness and mercies. He satisfies your mouth with good things. See, you have to get to the point where you look at it as, that's for me. Tú tienes que ponerte ahí y decir, he satisfies my mouth with good things. Instead of reading, who satisfies your mouth? No. Eventually, it's got to become yours. Eventualmente, tiene que venir a ser tuyo. You got to make it personal. Put your name, your presence right there. Tu nombre, tu presencia está aquí. You know? He heals all my diseases. He forgives all my iniquities. ¿Ve? Sana todas mis iniquidades, todas mis, él sana todas mis enfermedades. He redeems my life from destruction. ¿Ah? Él redime mi vida de la destrucción. Make it personal. Oh, no, no, I don't want to be like God. You got to do it that way. Tienes que entrar y hacerlo de esta manera. Oh, no, no, they speak loud. They, rah-bah-bah-bah. They do all that. I don't do all that. Ellos hablan alto. Ellos hacen rah-bah-bah. If I do anything, it's because I've been doing it for 43 years. Hello. Oh, that's the reason you do it, because you've been in there long. Yeah. Por eso lo hace, porque he estado ahí mucho tiempo. Yeah. But there are people that have been in there very long and still don't do it. Y hay gente que tiene mucho tiempo y todavía no lo hace. Why? Because they don't want to get in here. No entran aquí. Here's the secret. Not a secret anymore. It's out. Ya salió el secreto. Here's the benefits. Beneficios. You want them? Got it. I'm just showing you where they are. Now it's up to you at home. Yo te enseño dónde están los beneficios. Tú en tu casa, Salmo 103, lo vas a leer a solas. You're going to go home sometime this week and read Psalms 103. Voy a leer Salmo 103 for yourself. Make it personal. Hazlo personal. If you don't do nothing, then you come next Sunday. No hacen nada, viene otro domingo. Now here comes, either we continue or we go to another message. O continuamos este mensaje o hacemos otro. Pero cada vez sale algo. Every time something comes out of the pulpit, you're to do something about it during the week. Tú tienes que hacer algo de esto durante la semana. If not, then you're just religiously coming once a week. Religiosamente. I'm doing my duty. But that's good to show up. Está bien presentarte aquí en vivo. But your solution, your full coverage, your benefits, tu solución, la cobertura en total, la respuesta, todo viene en lo que tú pones en tu corazón creyendo. Whatever you put in your heart believing, and saying with your mouth, you'll see the results. Verás el resultado. You got the answer in the Bible. Tienes la respuesta en la Biblia. Amen. So, Psalm 68:19. Vaya para Salmo 68:19. In Psalm 68:19, it says, "Blessed be the Lord, bendito el Señor, who daily loadeth us with benefits." Cada día nos colma de beneficios. Even the God of our salvation. El Dios de nuestra salvación. Selah. Selah es medita en eso. Think about it. Selah means meditate. Ponder. Just meditate. Stop there. Daily. He daily gives me his benefits. He's the God of our salvation. Our completeness. Salvation is completeness. Salvation is nothing missing. Nothing broken. Salvación es nada vacío, nada quebrado, nada falta. Completeness, lo completo. That's from the Greek definition. De la definición del griego. Completeness. That's what salvation is. Es lo que es salvación. That's why we have to examine our lives. Why isn't things working out for me? Porque no está trabajando esta vida. Are you focusing, meditating on his word? ¿Estás meditando en su palabra? Are you speaking like him? ¿Estás hablando como él? Or he says this way, you speak like everybody else in the world. Él habla así, tú sigues hablando como el mundo. You know? He speaks life, abundance. Él habla vida, abundancia. But sometimes we speak death, hate, evil, muerte, odio, maldad. A veces hablamos de esas cosas, you know? Or you gotta be cool with the friends and start talking like they do. O te sientes bien de aquellas con los amigos que no son cristianos. There are friends that are not Christians, but you're involved with them still. Todavía sigues con ellos. And you won't change that way of talk because they're my friends. Son mis amigos. And you might be scared that if you don't say that, you may not be accepted by them. If I don't live or act like them, they might think I'm weird. Si yo no hablo o actúo como mis amigos, que ellos van a decir que soy raro. Well, what happened to what a friend we have in Jesus? What happened to that friend? He's more important. Jesús es más importante. I decided to make him my friend. And I've already told you, I can count my friends in my right hand, right here. Yo puedo contar a mis amigos, oh, how sad, Pastor Luis, you have no friends. Oh, Pastor, oh, I'm going to introduce introduce you to some people. Te voy a introducir. No, thank you. No, gracias. The Lord will tell me who I'm supposed to connect with. El Señor me dice con quién conectarme. So who are your people that you only know? Only a few, Pastor. My wife, my daughter. There's two. Mi esposa, mi hija. Ahí van dos. Reverend Oscar, there's three. Ministro José Luis, there's four. And maybe three or four, five of you, I don't know. Y algunos más de ustedes. So maybe there's more. Capaz hay diez. I don't need the friends I used to have. No necesito amigos que tenía. Because they're not Christians. They don't want to do what God says. Ellos no quieren hacer lo que Dios quiere hacer. They still want to drink, cause pornography, adultery, fornication. They still want to live that life. Todavía quieren vivir esa vida. Alcohol, drogas, fornicación, adulterio, mujeres, pornografía. They still want to live. Quieren vivir así. I don't want to live that way anymore. It's been 43. I've been away from all that. And I have to still resist all that all the time. Because I'm not in heaven yet. Todavía no estoy en el cielo. Así que yo tengo que estar resistiendo lo que ven mis ojos. Whatever my eyes see, I have to resist. You know? So, but no, I don't need friends like that. I'd rather have, what happens now is they call me to go pray for them. Ellos me llaman a mí para ir a orar por ellos. That's nicer. If they need that, okay. You know? Hallelujah. There's enough to do in life with your family and the church and your job. Hay suficiente que hacer con tu familia, la iglesia, tu trabajo. There's enough to do than to go hang out y de ir a andar con personas que no quieren cambiar. To be with people that just want to hang out at the park or just be, you know, talking dead. Hablar muerte nomás. That's why I said my friends are counted right here. You know? I know of people I can go visit and pray. But as soon as I know things are getting weird, I'm out. Cuando veo que la cosa está haciéndose toda fea en la... En el, okay, buenas noches, bendiciones. God bless you guys. Have a great night. God bless you. Do what you want to do, do it. I don't want to participate in that. Yo no quiero participar. With all due respect, you go ahead. I'm not telling you not to do it. You go ahead. You know? So, I live better that way. I have great peace, great sleep. It's wonderful. The Christian life. La vida cristiana es maravillosa. Gran paz, gran dormir. Oh, it's beautiful. Life is beautiful, I tell my wife all the time. La vida es bella. Once it's balanced, balance the Christianity, you know, mix your life with heaven, mezcla tu vida con el cielo. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. Gloria a Dios. Hallelujah. So did you get to Psalm 68? We already read it, right? Ya leímos ahí. Okay. Hallelujah. So, we know that God wants to load us with benefits. Sabemos entonces que Dios quiere llenarnos de beneficios. How often does he want to do this? ¿Cuántas veces quiere hacer eso? Diario. Daily. He wants to give us his benefits daily. Wow. Not like a check only once a week or every 2 weeks. No es como un cheque solo una semana o cada... No. Todos los días de tu vida, every day of your life, God wants to load you with benefits. Dios quiere llenarte de beneficios. Amen. Gloria al Señor. Hallelujah. So, is there any doubt that God wants believers to be blessed with abundant life? ¿Hay alguna duda que Dios desea que los creyentes sean bendecidos con una vida abundante? No. No, no hay duda. Dios desea que nosotros, Él quiere que nosotros tengamos una vida abundante. God wants us to have an abundant life. There's no doubt about it. Don't question it. No cuestiones eso. He wants an abundant life for you. Él quiere una vida. And you got to start believing and saying that. Tú tienes que creer en tu corazón y decir con tu boca, Dios quiere darme, quiere bendecirme con una vida abundante, diario. Dios me está bendiciendo con una vida abundante diariamente. God is blessing me with an abundant life daily. Now bring it to the present and faith says now. Tráelo al presente y háblale fe a lo que la palabra dice. Bring it to the present and speak faith over it as the word says it. Amen. Don't say one day God will. No, see, you're not in faith there.
Today.
Si dices algún día, no, ahora es la fe. Faith is now. So God wants to bless me today. He's blessing me with abundant life. Yeah. Hoy me está bendiciendo con una vida abundante. Why does God want us to be blessed with abundance? Why does God, and we're going to be closing in a few minutes now. Glory to God. Why does God want us to be blessed with abundance? ¿Por qué quiere Dios bendecirnos con abundancia? Well, there's two basic reasons. Hay dos razones básicas por qué Dios quiere bendecirnos con abundancia. There's two basic reasons why God wants to bless us with abundance. Okay? He wants us to experience the blessing of the abundant life. We know that. Él quiere que experimentemos la vida en abundante. So, number one, why does God want us to be blessed with abundance? ¿Por qué Dios desea bendecirnos con abundancia? Número uno, number one, God loves us and wants us to enjoy life.
Amen.
Number one.
Amen.
But why all this abundance? Because God loves you, porque Dios te ama. Aleluya. And he wants you to enjoy life. Y quiere que tú te goces de la vida. Oh, this life is so awful. I wish I wasn't living anymore. There's people that talk like that. Esta vida no vale. Yo no quiero vivir. Así hablan ciertas personas. That's how people talk sometimes. That don't know Jesus. Los que no conocen a Jesús. Amen. But we know Jesus. How many know Jesus here? ¿Cuántos conocen a Jesús? Aleluya. Gloria a Dios. So God loves us and wants us to enjoy life. That's why he wants us to be blessed with abundance. Dios nos ama y desea que nosotros nos gocemos de la vida. Por eso quiere que seamos bendecidos con abundancia. Number two, número dos. Why does God want me to be blessed with abundance, Pastor Luis? ¿Por qué Dios quiere bendecirme con abundancia? Number two, God loves others. Dios ama a otros y quiere que nosotros seamos un canal. God wants us to be a channel so he can bless others through us. Dios quiere usarlo a usted como canal para que él pueda bendecir a otro. No, let them get their own stuff. I work hard. Yo trabajo duro. Que ellos agarren su propio. That's not the way it should be. You should be so blessed in abundance. Debes estar tan bendecido en abundancia que debes estar listo para bendecir a otros por ti. Others should be blessed by you. Dio testimonio a la hermana hoy día. Sister Vilma gave a testimony today. Y hay muchos de ustedes que tienen testimonios así. Que el Señor les dijo que den esto y de pronto viene la bendición. God told you to do this. Y en un día, tres días, siete días, no sé, ¡pum! Doble, triple, cuadriple. More than one, two, three times. Quintuple of blessing. 1,000 times more than what you gave. Mil veces más de lo que tú diste. Amén. Gloria a Dios. So don't be stingy. ¿Cómo se dice stingy en español?
Codo.
Codo. Tacaño, codo. Don't be an elbow. Don't be stingy. You know? It can't be me, myself, and mine, no one else. Yo los míos y aquí, nadie más. You don't live that way. Christians do not live that way. Cristianos no viven así. Cristianos es me, myself, and whoever God tells me to bless. Yo, los míos, y el cual, donde Dios quiere que yo bendiga, ahí voy a bendecir.
Amen. Amen.
You gotta be ready that way. Yeah. You gotta be ready.
Amen.
You know. Y yo sé que ustedes tienen testimonios por el dar. I know many of you have testimonies because you're givers. When you give, there's testimonies.
Yes.
There's testimonies. Hallelujah. We can stay all day talking about testimonies. Whether we've given our life to someone, capaz le dimos la vida a alguien, to help, ayudar a alguien. You know, whether we stopped at the freeway and helped somebody change a tire. Si paramos en la carretera y ayudamos a cambiar la llanta de alguien, whatever. You do it unto the Lord. It's a giving principle. Tú se lo das al Señor. Es un principio de dar. You know? So, hallelujah. God wants you to be blessed and to be a blessing. Why does God want us to be blessed with abundance? ¿Por qué Dios quiere que seamos bendecidos con abundancia? Porque Dios quiere que tú seas bendecido y que tú seas una bendición. God wants us to be blessed and to be a blessing. To be a blessing to somebody. Amen. Amen. Gloria a Dios. Hallelujah. Now, it's a fact that the more you have, esta es una verdad, más que tú tengas in spiritual and material things, en cosas espirituales y en cosas materiales, the more you can give to others. Más puedes dar a otros. Huh? When somebody over here is not a giver, $5-$10 is hard to give. Cuando alguien no es un dador, $5-$10, oh man, that's a lot. But when you're a giver, here's $50. Go get some dinner. Aquí está 50, anda a comprarte algo. Huh? When you're a giver, that's the way it works. Because you get that and more in your life. But non-givers, it costs them to even get $5 or $10 out. It's like, they start saying, comienzan a decir, I can go and buy, I like this sandwich and fries and a soda. That's about $6.80. Nah, it's okay. I'm going to go eat better. But that's all. That's your blessing. That's your blessing. Your blessing is what you do for yourself. That's it. So you can't count on others giving to you. No cuentes con that because you're not a giver. But when you're a giver, you'll find people, here, no, I got it, brother. Yo lo tengo. Oh, all right, thank you. Here, put $40 in gas. Are you sure? Yeah, put $40 in gas. Oh, gracias, okay. I'm buying a shirt. You know what? You need a shirt. Let me bless you with a shirt. Come on, come here. What size are you? I'm going to buy you a shirt. I mean, givers are just like that. That's the life of givers. Hallelujah. Because it keeps coming in. When you give, it keeps coming in. Dice os dará. Give and it shall be given. Give and it shall be given. That's the life of a giver. That's the abundant life. Esa es la vida abundante. You see? So, go to 1 Timothy 6:17. Primera Timoteo 6:17. 1 Timothy. ¿Quién vive, hermanos?
Cristo.
Hallelujah. Who lives, my brothers? Jesus. Praise the Lord. Four English speaking there. Thank you, Lord. 1 Timothy. Gloria a Dios. Está clarito aquí, no necesito los lentes. Está bien clarito todo. Thank you, Lord. Aleluya, pastor. Amén. Gloria a Dios. ¿Algo más? Gloria. Santi. 1 Timothy 6:17. 6:17 de Primera Timoteo. Charge them that are rich in this world that they be not high-minded. They don't think of themselves like gran divina pomada. A los ricos de este siglo, manda que no sean altivos, que no se crean like, you know, the great divine gel. Move out of my way. I got my pompadour on, or hey, get out of my way. Don't be touching my hair. Get out of there. I don't wear no hats. Hats bother my hair. Leave it alone. You know, they think they're the great gel. La gran divina pomada. And it says here, charge them that are rich in this world that they be not high-minded. Don't think you're it. No te creas que tú eres. Nor trust in uncertain riches. Ni ponga la esperanza en las riquezas. Don't put your trust in riches. No ponga la esperanza en las riquezas. Put your, it says right here, put your hope in the living God. Dice aquí, pon tu esperanza en el Dios vivo. Givers, dadores, ponen su esperanza en el Dios vivo. If you're a giver, you're putting your hope in a living God, not in your money or your job, ni en tu trabajo, ni en tu dinero, ni en tu carro, or in your car, or what you have in savings, o lo que tiene en ahorro. Nobody knew the virus would have done this to the USA. But boom, it happened. Nadie supo cuando venía el virus, pero pasó. It's over. It came by. So don't ever trust in things. Nunca confíes en cosas. Because today they can be here, tomorrow, poof. Un humito, just a little smoke. Poof. ¿Qué pasó con todo eso? Poof, se fue todo. Se fue todo. But the same thing, when you do things with hope in God, Lo mismo cuando haces cosas con esperanza en un Dios vivo, en a living God, and you are doing that way by being rich. Y rico, confías en Dios más que en las posesiones. You trust more in God's living way instead of all this material stuff. You will give and you will receive. Darás y recibirás. You will never be without. Nunca estarás sin nada. You will have something all the time. Hallelujah. And it says here, it says, but put your trust in the living God who gives us richly all things to enjoy. Pon tu esperanza en, dice aquí, pon tu esperanza en el Dios vivo que nos da todas las cosas. If you put your hope in the living God, you get all things to enjoy. Todas las cosas para que las disfrutemos. And in Spanish it says, well, in English it says richly, who gives us all, us richly all things to enjoy. En español dice, que nos da todas las cosas en abundancia para que las disfrutemos. You will enjoy the great abundance God needs to give to you. Tú te gozarás de la gran abundancia que Dios te necesita dar a ti y que Dios necesita pasar por ti hacia otros. And that God wants to use you to pass to others. So this is a you and them. Esto se trata de ti y de ellos. God wants to bless everyone. Dios quiere bendecir a todos. Everyone. You know? And he wants to use us to be a testimony. Quiere que nosotros seamos usados como testimonio. I'm doing this because I know that God is awesome. He has blessed me so much. Yo hago esto porque Él me ha bendecido. If you haven't been blessed by God, how can you help someone else? Si tú no has sido bendecido, ¿cómo vas a ayudar a otro? But when you put your hope in a living God, cuando pones tu esperanza en un Dios vivo, y no en que yo soy la divina pomada del año, and now that I'm the great gel hairdo of the year, man, he says here, he'll give you richly all things to enjoy. Él te da todas las cosas en abundancia para que las disfrutemos. What does all things mean? ¿Qué significa todas las cosas? Todas las cosas. All things. All is all. Todas es todas. Amén. Gloria a Dios. Aleluya. Gloria a Dios. Gracias, Señor. So, verso 18. Verse 18. That they do good, that they be rich in good works, ready to distribute, willing to communicate. So he's telling us, right here to the rich, a los ricos, he says, do good, rich person. Haga bien, gente rica. Que sean ricos en buenas obras. God says, be rich in good works. Number one, good works, buenas obras. So you're doing good if you're rich and you're doing good works. Eres rico y estás haciendo buenas obras. You're doing okay, according to the Bible. Estás haciendo bien con la Biblia. Ready to distribute, dadivosos. Ready to distribute. You haven't been distributing? No, not yet. It's okay. Learn and practice it. Está bien si no has distribuido. Practícalo, apréndelo y practícalo. You know what I've learned? Whatever the Lord says, I just put it to work. Lo que Dios me haya dicho in my 43 years, I just, okay, el Señor dice que hay que hacer esto. The Lord says we got to do this. Huh? Because we can listen to all this and just go home and, no, yo no tengo suficiente para darle a todo. No. See, you're not rich. No eres rico, entonces. Your hope is in your money. Tu esperanza está en tu dinero. Your hope is not in the living God. Tu esperanza no está en un Dios vivo. Tu esperanza está en tu trabajo, tus bolsillos. My hope is in my pockets, my job, lo que tengo en la casa, el carrito que ando, my little car. That's my hope. Esa es mi esperanza. ¿Qué pasa si pierdes todo eso? What happens if you lose all the things you hope on?
Come on.
Permiso, pastor. Ya estuvo con mi vida. It's over. No, I don't have nothing now. Pow! Ya no tengo nada. Some people think that way in life. And they've done it.
Amen.
It's not a joke. No es un chiste. It's real. Amen. I have to act it out. Sometimes it comes out funny. A veces sale algo chistoso, pero yo no Es, con esto no se juega, es la vida de alguien. You don't play with that, somebody else. But that's what happens. Hay personas que sienten así, que ya no tengo nada. Because they put their hope in what they had. Pusieron su esperanza en lo que tenían. En sus $6,548 que tenían en el banco. I had $6,548 in the bank. Woo! Yeah! Woo! Wait, how much now? You only have $1,400. Oh no, $1,400! $1,400 es todo! Don't put your hope on that. No pongas tu confianza, tu esperanza en esas cosas. Gózate de todo eso, you know? Pero comienza a ser un dador. You want to have an abundant life? ¿Quieres tener una vida abundante? Practica dar. Practice giving. That, Luke 6:38. Give, it should be given back to you. Da, y se os dará. Gloria a Dios. Aleluya. Now, that was 18. That they do good, that they be rich in good works. He's talking about the rich in this world, a los ricos de este mundo. Dios dice, hagan bien. God says, do good, que sean ricos en buenas obras. Rich people, be rich in good works. Dadivosas, be ready to distribute and willing to communicate. Y generosos, generous. Yeah. But see, what happens in this world is that whenever you talk about money, you go like this. Whoa. Put my back against you. I don't want nobody touching my wallet. No quiero que nadie agarre mi cartera. No. See, your hope is not in a living God. Tu esperanza no está en un Dios vivo. Tu esperanza está en tu cartera. Your hope is in your wallet. Your hope is in your job. Tu esperanza está en tu trabajo. Your hope is in your savings. Tu esperanza está en tus ahorros. If everything's going down, you know what you need to do? Talk to God. Si está bajando todo, habla con Dios. Y Él te va a regresar a que tú hagas esto. Then He's going to say, what did Pastor Luis say? ¿Qué dijo el Pastor Luis de ese mensaje? De lo que es la vida abundante. Remember what Pastor Luis said in the abundant life? Why aren't you doing it? Porque no lo estás haciendo. Hermanos, va a tomar fe hacer esto. No hay un cierto día que este es el día. There's no right time. No hay un cierto día que este es el día correcto. It's by faith we start now. Por fe comienzo ahora. Eso es todo. That's all you do. Y si sientes que hay que pedir perdón, if you feel you have to ask for forgiveness, forgive me, Lord, I haven't been doing what you say. Perdóname que no he hecho. And that's it. You start right there. Forget the past. Olvídate del pasado. Comienzas en ese momento, right there. Ahí comienzas. That's it. Keep it simple. Instead of you slapping yourself and pulling your hair and, you know, hitting yourself. No, don't do that. No hagas eso. Te vas a lastimar. Slapping yourself, you're going to hurt yourself. Just ask for forgiveness and start right there. Pide perdón, comienza en ese momento lo que la palabra te está diciendo. Whatever the word is saying to you, do it right there. Simple. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Muy bien, let's go ahead and stop right here then. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let's stand. Póngase de pie. Hallelujah. We'll continue later on some more. There's some more to talk about. Why does He want to bless us with abundance? ¿Cómo experimentar la vida abundante? How to experience the abundant life. ¿Cómo experimentar la vida abundante? How do you experiment the abundant life? Starts with you. ¿Cómo experimentas la vida abundante? Comienza contigo. That's where it starts. Tú tienes que comenzarla. You got to start it. But how do I do it? I just told you certain things. Te dije algunas cosas. Tú tienes que... All these messages go on YouTube. You can always go to Jesus Amor USA. If you want, for you guys on Facebook, if you want to go to YouTube, Jesus Es Amor USA, that's where you get all these videos. Ahí agarras todos estos videos. Jesus Es Amor USA, that's where you'll get all these videos. And you say, that day I was at pastor's, or lo que vi por aquí, por el Facebook Live, just go to YouTube. Vaya a YouTube, ahí encontrará todos los videos. De Jesús es Amor USA. Ahí lo metemos. Y ahí otra vez puedes sentarte en tu casa. You can be at home, going over it by yourself. Ooh, yeah. Rich people, this is what they gotta do. Gente rica es lo que tienen que hacer. Do you know, just to close, para cerrar, do you know those billionaires in the world? Billonarios del mundo. You know, like Bill Gates. Eso que, now Bill Gates, is he the computer guy or de la computadora, Bill Gates? El otro de Facebook Live, un jovencito, a young person from Facebook Live. All those billionaires. You know what they do? ¿Sí sabe lo que ellos hacen? They give back millions. They give back millions. Regresan millones. Millones regresan a las comunidades. To non-profits, to people. Regresan millones. Bill Gates is not, I'm a billionaire. Nobody, get out of here. No. He's so rich because he gives back. Es tan rico porque él regresa. You want to stay rich? Keep giving out. Sigue dando para afuera. Todo lo que das, recibirás. Y we'll read Luke 6:38 and we'll close. San Lucas 6:38. Gloria a Dios. 6:38. Because I always say giving is given back to you. Da y se os dará. Pero ¿qué dice 6:18 en completo? Mi esposa le gusta leerlo completo. Pero yo estoy tan seguro que nomás da y se os dará. Yo estoy seguro con eso. Given is given back to you. I'm so secure in that. But look, 6. What is it? 6:38. Yes, thank you. Give and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down and shaken together. And running over, shall man give into your bosom? El hombre me va a dar algo a mí, pero yo nunca he recibido algo. Man's going to give something to me. I never receive anything. Porque no has dado, no recibes. Because you've never given, you never receive from men. Entonces dice aquí, for with the same measure that ye meet withal, it shall be measured to you again. En español, dad y se te dará. Medida buena, apretada, remecida y rebosando. Darán en vuestro regazo. Gente dará a ti. Pero, ¿en serio? Pero a mí nunca me ha dado nadie nada gratis. Es porque tú no has dado nada. Cuando tú des algo, comenzarán a dar algo a ti. You know? Dice, porque con la misma medida con que medís, os volverán a medir. ¿Cómo experimentar la vida abundante? How to experience the abundant life. You read every person that's a millionaire or a billionaire. Lee la historia de todo millonario y billonario. They're always giving back. Siempre están regresando algo. Here's $20,000 to help that park for the children of this community. 20,000 para ayudar a esos niños de esta comunidad a arreglar el parque para ellos. Whatever. That makes them feel great because they have so much. It's almost like, I got so much, I got to do something with this so more can come in. They know the secret already. Ellos ya saben el secreto. That you give and receive. That's the secret. El secreto es tú das, tú recibirás. That's it. Ay, pero no tengo tanto. Comienza con lo que tienes. But I don't have that much. Hazle un caldito a tu vecino. Get a soup ready and give it to your neighbor. Ay, sí, es que a veces se pone todo enojón ahí. Está enfermo. He's sick right now. No tiene que darle dinero. Él no necesita dinero en la cama de enfermedad. Él necesita un caldito de pollo. Y llévaselo. Aquí le traigo don en el nombre de Jesús. Tome. And give him a soup. Ahí comienza el dar. ¿Ah? Y de repente tú ves que, ay, antes me faltaba, ahora ya no me falta nada en mi cocina. I used to miss a lot of things. Now I'm so packed with things in my kitchen. Because you started doing something for someone else. Now you're entering into the abundant life. Ahora entraste en la vida abundante. What did Gloria do? We had a sister here named Gloria. She had a car, tenía un carro, and she bought a brand new one, cash. But first, she gave her car away to somebody. Regaló un carro a una familia que caminaba. It was a husband, a wife, and a little baby. They will walk to church every Sunday. Caminaban a la iglesia. And he said, come up here. Here's the key to my car. It's working good. I'm going to plant it in you. Because I'm believing for a new car. Yo creo al Señor un nuevo carro. She got herself cash. Una Latina pagó por un carro cash. Por dar un carro, recibió su carro nuevo. She gave a car and got a new car for that. And that family was their first car. They ever started traveling to church. Para ir a la iglesia, iban en ese carro. And there's many stories we can tell you that has happened through Jesús' Amor ministries. Hay mucho que ha pasado por el ministerio de Jesús' Amor. Hay mucha gente que ha sido bendecida en lo que es la vida abundante, in what it is of the abundant life. So, la José Luis says, don't be elbow. No seas elbow. No seas el codo. Don't be hard. No seas duro.
Que no duela.
¿Eso quiere decir que no duela?
Que no le duela.
O que no le duela. Ok. O yo pensé que no seas duro. En suave. Ponte más suave. Don't be hard. Be soft.
No seas codo.
No seas codo. Love. Camina en amor. Father, we thank you. We praise you. That we are experimenting the abundant life. Le damos gracias que estamos experimentando la vida abundante. Every day we are experimenting the abundant life. Todos los días estamos experimentando la vida abundante. We're all going to have opportunities to do what God told us to do, what He wants people to do. Todos los días vamos a tener oportunidad de hacer lo que Dios nos dice en su palabra. De no hacerte el tan gran yo soy. Don't be the great I am. Él es el único yo soy. He's the only I am that I am. Tú obedeces su palabra y puedes ser un rico en la tierra. You obey his word, you'll be a rich person on earth. But make sure that when you're rich, you must plant seed. Para ser rico, tienes que seguir plantando semilla. Don't put it all away in your bank. No lo guardes todo. Because something can happen to a person and the government takes all that money. Si tu familia no está conectada a ese dinero, el gobierno se lleva todo ese dinero. ¿Dónde está esta persona? Oh, ya no está aquí, murió y ya no tiene hermano, hermana. Bueno, vamos, mételo a California. Put the money into California, then. Más para el California. So, planea bien tu vida. Plan your life well, according to the Bible. De acuerdo a la Biblia. Amén. Gracias, Señor, en el nombre del Padre, el Hijo, el Espíritu Santo, te damos gracias. Que nosotros nos recordemos de esta vida abundante. I pray in the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, that we may remember this message of the abundant life. Because we are living in abundance right now. Estamos viviendo en abundancia ahora en el nombre de Jesús. Y te damos la gloria y la honra. We give you glory, honor, and praise. Y todos decimos, amén, amén. Damos gracias a Facebook. God bless you, Facebook. Congregation, we'll see you again. Apostle Luis Chacón from Iglesia Jesús Amor en La Puente, California. Nos vemos pronto en el nombre de Jesús. Aleluya.